Assalamu-Alaikum.
Walaikum Assalam.
How was your school today?
It was good, uncle. How was your work?
It was fine, Abu. So, have you finished your homework?
Yes, uncle. I had finished that as soon as I reached home.
Very good, Abu. So, are you ready for the story then?
I am, uncle. Which story are you going to tell me today?
Inshallah. I'll tell you the story of Hazrat Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu today. Are you ready?
Yes, uncle. I am.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The story of Hazrat Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Ammar bin Yasir was one of the muhajirin in the history of Islam. Muhajirins were the first set of people who got converted into Islam. Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu is considered to be one of the most loyal and beloved companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was one of the most reputed and respected companion. He was the first Muslim to build a mosque in his own house to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu belonged to Banu Makhzum tribe in Arabia. He was born in the same year as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born. His father's name was Yasir. He had lost one of his brothers when he was young. He accompanied his father along with his two brothers when they went searching for his lost brother. They traveled to Mecca to find him. After they finished searching for their lost brother in Mecca, his brothers returned to their homeland. But Yasir chose to stay back in Mecca. Yasir had no house to live in Mecca. So he entered into a covenant with a rich man named Abu Hudhaifa. Yasir agreed to marry his slave girl, Sumayyah Bint Khayyat. Yasir and Sumayyah lived happily, and they had two sons. Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the second son, but he was considered to be the slave of Abu Huzaifa as per the custom prevailing in Arabia. Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his parents were among the first to convert to Islam. Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu converted to Islam under the direct influence of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was the father-in-law of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The situation in Mecca was not favorable for the Prophet's followers during those times. The people in Mecca belonged to either of the two classes, the rich or the poor. The rich persecuted the poor and subjected them to harsh treatments. The poor people mostly worked as slaves. They had nothing, not even their freedom. The rich people controlled the weak and made them suffer a lot. No one was there to support the weak and the poor. The most prominent leaders of Mecca were from the Qurayshi tribe. Qurayshi leaders were traders and they were very rich. Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his parents were the slaves to their master Abu Huzaifa, who was a companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After the death of Abu Huzaifa, a rich man named Abu Jahl took Ammar and his family as his slaves. Abu Jahl later became one of Islam's most brutal enemies. When Yasir got converted to Islam, the news soon reached Abu Jahl, his new master. He was very angry at his servant. He led a group of men from the Quraysh tribe and went to Yasir's house. They threw flaming torches on Yasir's house and burned down his house. Yasir and his family were sleeping when this happened. And when fire caught up, they got up. They saw that their house was in flames and ran out for saving their lives. They were shocked to see the furious Qurayshi men waiting for them outside. The Qurayshis caught them and took them to a desert outside Mecca. They tortured them without showing any mercy. Some of the men were laughing while family cried out in pain. In spite of all the tortures, they were not ready to give up their new faith. When Abu Jahl found that Yasir and family were not ready to give up on their love towards Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he started torturing them more brutally. He ordered rocks to be put on their chests. They were not able to breathe properly, but still they kept their faith close to their heart. It was noon. Abu Jahl and his men left Yasir's family in the desert under the scorching sun. He came back to Mecca. When it was evening, Abu Jahl and his men came back. Abu Jahl was leading the group. There was a long spear in his hand. He began torturing them with the spear. He found extreme happiness in doing so. Due to the severe torture with the spear, Ammar, Yasir and Sumayyah went unconscious. The men then showered them with water to wake them up. When they got up again from unconsciousness, Abu Jahl started shouting at them. He shouted at Sumayyah and asked her to praise the pagan gods and curse their beloved prophet. Sumayyah was a brave lady. She closed her ears when she heard what Abu Jahl said. She spat on his face with anger. In extreme anger, Abu Jahl raised his spear high and stabbed her. Sumayyah died that day. Sumayyah radiallahu ta'ala anha, mother of Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, became the first martyr in the history of Islam. Abu Jahl started torturing Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu's father Yasir and killed him also. He too refused to move away from his faith and loyalty towards his beloved prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu saw what happened to his parents and he wept. He was really helpless. Abu Jahl started shouting at Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu and threatened him that if he did not praise the pagan god, he will be tortured and killed. Ammar could not endure that cruel torture, so he reluctantly agreed to praise the pagan god. After Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu started praising the pagan god, Abu Jahl unchained him and allowed him to escape. He started his journey to meet the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He loved the Prophet very much that he knew Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will help him to get back to his life.
Oh Allah, I feel really sad after listening this story. How much he had suffered.
He suffered a lot. But that was a life-changing incident in his life. I'll tell you some more detailed story of Ammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu after the lunch. You'll come to know why he is an inspiration to many. Okay. Come on, let's have some lunch.
Sure, uncle.